Daytona Beach, Florida, home to Hanksters Hot Rods Muscle Car and Collector Car Showroom, America's number one choice for premier collector cars for over 30 years. Today we have a Hanksters certified unit to present to you. We move a lot of units through our showroom, not only here in Daytona Beach, but also in our Pennsylvania location. This car today is probably one of the most desirable pieces of inventory that I've had the pleasure of running through Daytona here. We've had this car before in the past. Being that we're in the business, we deal with a lot of collectors, investors that, you know, trade out cars and whatnot over time. I've known the previous owner of this car. I know the gentleman who owned the car before the gentleman we bought it from. So I'm very familiar with this particular vehicle. 1970 U-code Plymouth Cuda. Numbers matching 440 car. U-code Cuda means a start of life with a 440 in it. So let's check it out. First of all, you'll notice 440 six-pack. So this is not a six-pack motor. It has the six-pack setup on it. What is the difference? The internals of a six-pack motor are different than the internals of a regular 440. So the car started life as a U-code car, not a V-code car. It is not a true six-pack motor. However, it is the numbers matching 440 for this particular car. The fender tag is present. We will have a photo of it on our website for you to break down if you choose to. It is a power brake car. The car is equipped with power brakes. There is no power steering in the car, and there is no AC. So not only is it a desire, so not only numbers matching motor, but also numbers matching transmission. It is an automatic car and does have the complete original drivetrain in the vehicle. So, red, one of the most desirable colors. You have a numbers matching motor, numbers matching transmission, resell red, black vinyl top. Let's check out the hood. The paint on the hood and the top of the fenders, real nice uniform color and clear. No issues, blisters, bubbles, cracks, clear coat fade, anything like that going on this particular car. Grill. Grill on the car is nice. No cracks, not broken anywhere, no heavy fading going on. The front bumper, the chrome on the front bumper is in pretty nice shape. There are some like water spots that like won't come off, but overall the chrome condition is really nice. Good clarity out of the chrome, no peeling, no rust around the bumper bolts, anything like that. The front fender on the driver's side. No paint issues whatsoever. I don't think there are any paint issues on this car, but we're going to check it out completely here in this video. But on the front fender, there are none. Real nice color, clear, no Bondo cracks, anything like that. Now, wide oval Firestone tires. Those are bias ply tires. These are not radial tires. I left the bias ply on the car for reasons of, you know, that's really what they're supposed to be on there. So I'm leaving those on there. If you want radials, you know, we can switch them out, but those are the bias ply tires for the car. Beauty rings, center caps look to be in nice shape. Five lug chrome, those look to be in good condition, not rusted or pitted. Glass clarity on this car is really nice. Let's start out with the front windshield. No cracks or chips in it. The chrome that encompasses the front windshield also in nice shape. No issues going on up top here, above the windshield as far as the vinyl top's concerned. Down your A-pillar, it's also in nice shape. We'll have a photo of the VIN on our website as well. Chrome mirrors, dual, one on the driver door, one on the passenger door. Glass clarity on the driver's side of the car, door glass in nice shape. There is a little stain right there. It's probably the same water stain that's on the front bumper that won't come out. But the quarter glass there, that's also in nice condition. I personally believe, I'm not a professional body man, I don't claim to be, but I personally believe this car is all original sheet metal or close to it. Maybe not every last panel, but you know, the door fitment on this car in the body lines, I mean, I don't see any presence of any kind of filler or Bondo whatsoever. The car has real nice lines down the side of it, doors, fenders, quarters, it all lines up nicely. It does have that rocker, that like finned rocker molding down there too, that is supposed to be on the car. That's in nice condition. Check out the driver's side portion of the interior, starting with the door panel. Look at how nice that door panel is inside. No cracks, no fading, the armrest isn't torn. How about inside the car? Back seat. Rear seat belts, vinyl's in good shape, interior's in good shape, dome light illuminates when I open up the driver door, headliner's in nice condition. Seat back looks good. It's not falling off the driver's seat, it's not all scratched, torn, ripped up. The driver's seat here, condition of the vinyl on the seat back and on the seat bottom. Real nice shape. Cuda floor mats. The carpeting underneath the floor mat in pretty good condition. It does look like it's an older carpeting. It's not faded or heavily discolored in any way. It just doesn't look brand new. So it's got some age to it. Wood steering wheel. The correct Cuda steering wheel. That's in good shape. Yeah, we look pretty good. Like I mentioned earlier, it's an automatic car, so you got a center console there between your bucket seats and the automatic shifter. We'll check out the interior closer when we're on the test drive. Let's look at the rear quarter of the car. Starting with the drop down from the roof to the rear quarter on the vinyl top, that looks in good shape. And then there's no issues on the rear quarter in terms of any kind of paint imperfections, blisters, bubbles, cracks. It's a pretty nice paint job on this car. I do not have a history of when it was done. I can tell you I've known the car for the last 8 years, and it hasn't been done in 8 years, so I can tell you it's at least 9 years old. Glass clarity out of the rear windshield here in nice condition. Your chrome that encompasses the rear window, that's in nice shape. Looks like some Pioneers there in your speaker shelf area. We'll figure out if that works on the test drive. Your vinyl top condition here behind the rear window, no issues there to speak of. Deck lid fits outstanding to the rear quarters. And then the rear of the car looks to be in pretty good shape. Your rear tail panel here, nice and black, not discolored or faded. The chrome on your rear bumper, that's not peeling off. Rusted. Your dual exhaust there that comes out of the lower valance of the vehicle. This is a good looking car. A very good looking car. Look at that documentation. So you have build sheet. I think this is like a remake. I do not believe that's the original build sheet, but build sheet has a Govier report. Yeah, so all that documentation will come with the car when you get it. Gives you the fender tag breakdown. We'll have that photo on our website. Oh, let me lift up. Let me get this out of the way. And I'll show you the trunk. Which side do I want to go here? Let's go to this side. No issues with the trunk pan, nice and solid. Even got a little light that works when you open up the deck lid. How about that? So you can see what you're doing when you're putting your groceries in the trunk of your 1970 U-Code Cuda. All right, passenger side, body line's fantastic. Rear quarter, fantastic. I don't know how much I can say about this car. This car is outstanding. I love it. The color, the condition, what it is. I mean, it's just, we don't get to move many Cudas through here for the reason that, you know, you can't buy them. Either the people don't want to part with them, or if they do want to part with them, they're, you know, $50,000 more than you can afford to pay for them, or whatever the circumstances are. We're just, you know, we're very fortunate to be able to have not only this particular car, but it being red and documented and fender tagged and all that stuff that comes with the Mopar desirability of collectors, you know, collecting these cars. The vinyl top here on the passenger side, same as the driver's. You know, your top in nice shape, your seams are in nice shape, around the drip rail molding's in nice condition. Look how tight that door closes on the passenger side of the rear quarter. Nice tight fit. That means all your body panels are lined up like they should be. Take a step back from the car and look at the door fitment on the passenger side. You see that? How the gaps here to the front fender and to the rear quarter, how they're nice and uniform, and that door fits just like it should. Again, that means the fender, the door, the quarter, it's all lined up like it should be. The body lines line up. It's a nice straight car. Passenger side. Door panels just as nice as the driver's was. The seat there on the passenger side, check that out. Again, not torn, they have good cushion to them. The center console's in nice shape. The courtesy lights are shining in the floor when you open up the door. Great looking car inside and out. We'll conclude by checking out the bottom of the passenger door, passenger side front fender. All that stuff, the Pentastar there on the front fender on the passenger side down low. So you don't think that's a rust bubble down there. Plymouth, Chrysler, Dodge, they actually put that on there in the 70s, 60s and 70s. Okay. First we're gonna rack it, then we're gonna drive it. Outstanding car. And I want to make sure you agree with me, and that's why I invite you to come in person to check this vehicle out for yourself at our Daytona Beach showroom. We are in the business of selling 30, 40, 50-year-old cars. They've been repainted. They've had drivetrain changeouts. They've had interior changeouts, dash changeouts, so on and so forth. This car is a little more original than you know, the normal run-of-the-mill, like 68 or 69 Camaro, something like that. But nevertheless, they're old. They have weaknesses, deficiencies, some of which we try to point out in these video presentations, but we don't have an hour to do them. We try to disclose as much as we possibly can, as much as we possibly know about the vehicle in the time frame allotted. However, when you're here, you can go over the car yourself in its entirety. You can check out the paint and the interior condition outside in a natural sunshine, although today you might want to do it in our showroom that's like 74 degrees versus outside, which was like 104 degrees. But we'll put it on the rack for you, and we'll let you check out the undercarriage, the floor pans, the suspension components, bottom of the motor, transmission. We'll let you drive the car. You can see how it steers, how it accelerates, how it stops, handles, rides, performs, and so on and so on. This way, when the vehicle is delivered to you, wherever you might be located at, in the United States or in the world, there are no surprises because you were here and you went over the car for yourself. We sell a lot of sight unseen units. In fact, that's how the majority of our business is conducted. The gentleman I originally sold this car to, twice. The first one we shipped it to, the second one actually came in person and got it, drove it home and trailered it home, as a matter of fact. But nonetheless, you know, if you come here, you'll know exactly what you're buying. We do a lot of sight unseen business, but they're old cars. So if you have higher expectations or you're a more specific or particular buyer, visit us yourself, check out the paint yourself, check out the mechanics for yourself, and this way you know exactly what you're signing up for, and there's no surprises when the car arrives. Let's put our 1970 Cuda up in the air, and we'll check out the undercarriage of this vehicle. Underneath our 1970 U-Code Cuda, disc brakes up front. So the numbers matching portion of this block, which is right here, will be on our website. You can look up there and you can see January 20th, 1970 is the date code on the block. So numbers matching motor. Numbers matching transmission on this car, like we stated earlier. There is your partial VIN for the transmission, which we will also have a photo of on our website. Now, I know because of the size of our camera and because of the lighting underneath the car, you're not going to be able to see the partial VINs, but they are there. And it is a true numbers matching drivetrain on a U-Code Cuda from 1970. Let's take a look at the oil pan. Oil pan looks nice and dry at this time. Same thing with the tranny pan. Trans pan on this car looks good. Frame rails, those look good. Cross members supporting the transmission up, that looks good. Exhaust pipes, they come down off of our dual manifolds into an H-style setup and then back out the exhaust. Dual mufflers we'll show you here momentarily. In my personal opinion, I would say that they're the original floor pans on the car, or the undercoating that's been put on this car was done quite some time ago, because that either looks factory or it definitely looks like it was from the 70s. That is not something we did to the car. And that is not something that you know, you see today. It's definitely something that's older, for sure. The rear of this car has drum brakes. Frame rails in the rear here look good, driver's side. Passenger side, driver's side, well, I kind of got that backwards, but you know what I mean. Passenger side, driver's side, both look good. Exhaust system, no rust holes, rot holes, pinholes in any of it. That all looks nice and solid throughout. It's time to go drive it. I remember last time I drove this car. Let's set this thing down on the ground. We'll take it on a test drive and show you how it runs. Before we do that, let's talk about our payment options. If you're a cash buyer, we accept cashier's check from your bank and bank wire transfer. If you're financing, the lending institutions we work with will do 5 to 15 year loans on these cars. 10% down of the purchase price. They might require more if your debt to income is a little higher or your credit score is a little lower, but it's a minimum of 10%. No matter how good your credit is, if it's a $50,000 car, you're talking about $5,000 down. So once the vehicle is paid in full, we put the car through a pre-delivery inspection. They are old vehicles. Anything can start leaking, stop working in any given moment. Therefore, we put the car through one last shakedown prior to it leaving our facility and heading your direction. Once it's through inspection, we put the vehicle through detail, and then a carrier is dispatched if we are the ones handling the shipping. We can typically have a truck here within a 48-hour window. However, if you're in a more difficult destination, you're on the West Coast, you're out in the middle of nowhere, you know, please allow us six business days, but we will get a truck here as quickly as we can and get you your vehicle as quickly and as safely as possible. If you're handling your own shipping, coming to get the car, sending your own carrier, bringing your own trailer, we'll let you know when it's ready and you can come pick it up. Let's set our 70U code CUDA down on the ground and we'll take it on a test drive. Okay, we ready? Horn. Driver's side turn. We had the top indicator out there on the fender, but we lost it, so we gotta jiggle that back to life or put a new bulb in it. We do have the passenger still, though. Now we have the passenger on the inside as well. While we're there, tack. 47,279 is the miles on the odometer. Title reads exempt. This clock's ticking, if you can believe that. Fuel gauge works, temp works, oil works, alternator works, the radio works. Never, yeah! Okay, it's hot today, so no air, so we're just gonna have to drive faster. Headliner's good, dash pad's good. Center console's in pretty nice shape. Okay, let's see what this 440's got in it, I guess. Okay, CUDA, speedo, 50 miles an hour, right on the money, not shaking around. Our temp's good. We're at it's about 110 out here, and we're probably running, I don't know, 190, 195, something like that. So that's a good thing. It's not a power steering car, so got a little bit more play in the wheel, but it's still responsive. The 440 has nice performance. Motor doesn't vibrate, tranny doesn't vibrate, tires, believe it or not, don't vibrate. Keep in mind, we're on bias ply tires on 180 degree asphalt. Brakes, look at, brakes stop the car perfectly. No vibrations or pulsations out of the front rotors whatsoever. Okay. Am I gonna get the clear?
Oh, no, damn it.
Almost. Yeah, we'll get it up to, I don't know, 65, 70 miles an hour, depending on how much road we have. See, he likes it. How much road we have in front of us. Idling nicely, not stalling out, not overheating. Got the thing out. All right, I'm gonna go. Ready? I lied, that's 80. So I just had it up to 80, got a little bit of tire hop up front because they're bias ply tires, but here we are at 60. Okay, car is tracking straight, it's holding the road, it's not overheating. This is a lovely car. I like it. This will be the one of the most memorable sales of the year, that's for sure. A fantastic car. It'll be interesting to see how much activity, well, not how much activity, we'll get a ton of activity on the car, but how fast it sells, being that it's red, has a fender tag, it has a build sheet, it's documented, numbers matching motor, numbers matching trans, great color, great interior combination, working radio, working clock, the list goes on and on and on. There's no reason not to buy this car. The last 70 Cuda I sold was in California. It was an orange car. Numbers matching motor, not a numbers matching transmission. I think that car lasted a week. 386-944-19, and that was a numbers matching 340 car, not a numbers matching 440 car. 386-944-9219 is our contact phone here in Daytona Beach. Hanksters.com is our website. It's where you can find all the photos of this vehicle along with this video presentation you're watching right this very moment. At full retail price, our U-code CUDA includes shipping in the lower 48 United States on an enclosed carrier. It also includes a powertrain warranty that covers the internal components of the engine, the transmission, and rear end. It does not cover oil pan gasket leaks, tranny pan gasket leaks, starters, alternators, batteries. It does, however, cover major mechanical breakdowns of your powertrain. Is the price of this car negotiable? Within reason, it is. If we negotiate the price of the car, the warranty comes off. Warranty is good at full retail price only. Also, the shipping comes off. At full retail price, we vest the driver, make sure they've been in business more than 2 days to carry this beautiful automobile for you. We arrange the pickup at our showroom. We arrange the delivery to you. We pay the driver when they pick up the vehicle. We track the progress of the shipment from the time it leaves our showroom to the time it's dropped at your location. At a negotiated price point, you will do all that legwork on your own. Maybe you're a collector or an investor, you've had a carrier you've used in the past, you had a good experience with, or you have your own trailer, you're more than welcome to trailer this car home. Make a couple day trip here to Daytona, there's a lot of cool restaurants on the water, the beach, the speedway, a lot of fun stuff to do, a lot of shopping for the ladies. And if you're local to us here in the Sunshine State, why not drive this thing home? It'd be a cool ride, you get a lot of thumbs up on your way home, maybe stop and have a little lunch somewhere. Hanksters Hot Rods is located in Central Florida, Daytona Beach. And once again, our website is hanksters.com. Check us out.